What's going on, gamers? Today, we are going to go over how to set up and play the Volcano Block Minecraft Modpack. Before we get started, don't forget to like, subscribe, and click that notification bell to stay up to date on all future videos. Vanilla Minecraft is relatively easy for most players, and there are a ton of resources available around the world. But if you're looking for a new type of challenge, then let's talk about the Volcano Block Modpack, which forces players to complete quests to progress in the map. You're surrounded by a fiery sea of lava on a small island with almost no resources. Whether you're enjoying the challenges alone or with friends, this pack creates an enjoyable and challenging gameplay experience for everyone. Any players wanting to enjoy this mod pack will need to install it on the CurseForge launcher, so let's start with that. Head towards CurseForge and then click Download for your operating system. Save the launch file somewhere on your computer and then you can start the installation. And once it's fully installed, run the program and click Browse Mod Packs in the menu. Enter Volcano Block in the search field and then press Install. And after that, just press play from your My Mod Pack section to confirm the install. After preparing the launcher, you're also going to have to review these steps to start setting up your Volcano Block server. Head towards your Apex server panel and find the game file section near the bottom. Once you find that, click on the currently selected option to reveal a drop-down menu and search for Volcano Block in the text box. Once you find it, you can press it, and in the following prompts, you can choose to change the version and create a new world. After that, press Restart Now to start loading everything on your server, and once it's fully loaded, you can join with your Volcano Block profile on CurseForge. When you first enter the world, you're going to notice a small platform of grass blocks surrounded by cobblestone in a sea of lava. This is your only area to play with, but you will be able to expand it later on. Besides this, you're also going to notice two items in your inventory, a quest book and a wooden knife. The book is used to manage your quests. There are many chapters to complete, which all provide rewards and information to help you advance in-game. As for the second, it's mainly used to complete the first quest. Accessing the starter quest involves right-clicking with the book in your hand and then selecting it in the menu. Doing this allows you to see what tasks need to be completed and what rewards you're going to receive afterwards. Make sure not to lose this book, but it doesn't need to stay in your hotbar because you can also access it from your inventory in the top left corner. Beginning your first quest requires you to hold the wooden knife and then shift and right-click. This is going to slice some of your character's flesh off needed for the quest tasks. Be cautious when you're doing this though, because your health depletes pretty quickly every time you do it, and if you go too fast, you'll be dead before you can even get started. If you're in a dire situation, you can also replenish your HP by eating your flesh, but it's best to avoid doing this because it's pretty vital for the next task. After obtaining your own flesh, simply place it anywhere in your crafting area from the inventory. This is going to produce bone meal, which is required to complete the first mission. Once you do this, head towards your quest book area and continue to take your reward from the So It Begins option. Doing this will complete it and allow you to move forward in Chapter 1. It might be best to collect lots of bone meal because you're going to need some extra in the future. After you've obtained the bone meal, you can right-click on the grass blocks with it. This is going to spawn vegetation on them, allowing you to collect seeds, sticks, sugarcane, and other materials. The most important ones are the sticks, since you're going to have to craft a wooden hoe with them. A minimum of 3 is required to make this tool, but feel free to click on it from the quest book to learn its recipe. Once you've gathered enough seeds, start placing them on the farmland blocks. This is going to help you progress through other quests while also providing food for your character. If you want crops to grow faster, then you can right-click them with the bone meal to do that. A popular tip is to constantly spawn vegetation with the bone meal to collect more seeds, since there are tons of them to find in the grass. After farming for a short while, you'll reach the Some Strange Seeds quest. This is only completed after obtaining specific seeds from breaking your spawned vegetation. After completing this mission, one of the rewards is a Guide to Unique Crops book. Opening this in-game allows you to research strange and useful crops to grow. We're going to review some popular ones, but keep in mind that others are available and they will be needed to finish future quests. The most useful crop in the early game is Artesia, since it allows you to obtain a crafting table. It's going to instantly drop this once it's harvested, which can then be used to make a crafting station. Before doing any of this, you're going to need to collect 4 Normie seeds to make Artesia seeds. This is a requirement for the quest, plus other ones later on in your adventure. Another useful crop to try is Precision, allowing you to obtain random helpful items or materials after harvesting it. This doesn't happen every time, since there's only a small chance of it occurring though, so make sure to look for visual cues when the crop grows, since this is going to indicate if it'll drop something instead of nothing. This isn't needed for an exact quest in Chapter 1, but it is going to help your progression. If you're wanting lots of food to sustain your hunger, then growing these plum crops will help. These automatically drop items that are used to create a large plum. Make sure to collect them right away because they can rot if they're left unattended. Once you eat these items, you're going to float for a short period of time, so be mindful of your player's position so that you don't end up falling into the lava. After finishing more quests, the tasks are slowly going to become more difficult over time. For example, you're going to need to grow wheat for hay bales to use for other activities. A critical point during the gameplay will be the Cobblonia Seeds quest, since this permits you to collect cobblestone. This is going to help you create many useful tools, items, and blocks to grow your island. Make sure your priority is completing quests, but also always be collecting resources to exponentially expand your building area. After finishing all of the Chapter 1 quests, you're going to find yourself in the second one. The first item in Chapter 2's introduction is a food book, giving you more information on what players can eat. It'll also keep track of how many you've tried in-game, making it kind of a notebook for your progression. Later on in the chapters, you're also going to notice countless quests and interesting rewards. Eventually, you can even obtain a dragon egg, meaning there's a ton of potential during your adventure. If you have issues on the panel, then make sure you're either using a new server profile or making sure that no previously existing files are conflicting with the install. However, manually installing the pack is also an option if you're still having issues. As for the launcher, re-downloading the mod pack should resolve any problems. If your world isn't lava when you enter, when you select the mod pack on the server panel, make sure you're choosing to create a new world to generate the correct map for the mods. This appears in the prompt after the Change Version button, so make sure not to miss it. Otherwise, you can load it in single player and follow the tutorial linked down below to upload the world files into your server. This mod pack is a great way to try something new while still having an exact guide to follow to get you to progress through the game. It's definitely not your vanilla gameplay, but it's really interesting to see how far you can get before you end up falling into the lava below. That's all for this one. As always, I hope you have lots of fun.
Thanks for watching. If you want to see more great content like this, then subscribe or click these videos. Until next time, gamers.